Good afternoon, guys. My name is Kenny, and you're watching Brave the Wilds on YouTube. What I want to do is I want to do a series starting today on building a really solid and something that's going to last a long time cabin kitchen setup. This could be for your cabin, or it could be for, you know, a workshop, anything that you really want some type of area where you can work and have a sink and maybe possibly do food prep or anything like that. Mine is going to go in my simple 10x20 cabin. It's nothing special. It's just 1x8 boards with 2x4s for support or walls. Really nothing special, but it's going to be a really good medium for us to test out this setup and hopefully show you guys a really good tutorial-based setup and video series on how to make it. I'm going to go through step by step. I'm going to try and show all the steps that I can. So part one today is going to be the design and a little bit of preliminary building. And then from there on, we will go to building the cabinet doors and shelves and mice-proof areas to keep store food, the sink itself, and all those types of things. So the cabinets or the cabinet itself is really only going to be about 5 feet wide, and the countertop is only going to be about 5'7". So you're really only looking about 5.5 feet of space taking up in your cabin or your shop, whatever you're using. And you could easily adapt that or make it a little bit smaller, a little bit bigger, depending on your preference and depending on your size constraints. So what I'm going to start with is I drew out a design on a piece of paper, and so I will lay that out for you here. We're going to go over a couple dimensions, and then we're going to go ahead and start working on the base cabinet itself. You guys may be asking why I'm doing a video on this and why I'm not just using the cabinet setup that I just put in not too long ago. Well, it was made out of particle board and cheap veneer, and it's after the flood this summer. It got wet and it just hasn't dried out, and I was afraid of mold and I could smell something that I knew was mold, so I decided to go ahead and rip it out, take it to the dump, and we're going to be starting on something today that shouldn't have any problems with that and will last a long time. If you guys want, you can stain it. I'm not going to stain mine. I'm not going to worry about it. That will help protect it, or you can also make it out of pressure treated wood, which will make it rather expensive. This way is going to be very cheap. Mine's going to be free, basically, but, well, with about a $20 sheet of plywood, and that's pretty much all I spent. But if you wanted to do it out of pressure treated, it would last a lot longer, but it would be a bit more expensive. So I'm going to go ahead and stop talking. Let's go ahead and lay out the paper, and we'll start on the dimensions and the preliminary building. Okay, well, I'm really, really hoping you guys can see this. I'm afraid that you can't. It doesn't look like it, but I might get lucky and it show up on the video a little bit better than what it is now on the camera screen, but we'll see. And if not, I will take a picture of it or something and try and get it up on the video in some type of way that you can see it. But I'll go and point out the main reference points and the dimensions, and we'll move on from there. So basically, the countertop is going to be a little bit bigger than the base. Obviously, we're going to have a 2-inch overhang. Sorry, I keep hitting the camera. We're going to have a 2-inch overhang on the left side and a 5-inch overhang on the right side. The reason for that is the right side is going to have a rolling spark arrestor for the fireplace that slides underneath the right side. If you guys are curious what I'm talking about, just watch my cabin renovations part one, the rolling spark arrestor, and you'll figure out what I'm saying. And it's actually already set up there, and you'll understand exactly what I'm saying. So that will be the way that's set up. We're going to have the sink where it always is. It's right in the middle. Actually, there's a 3-inch offset. And that offset is to the left, I believe. And that will give us just a little bit more room on the right for a piece of sheet metal that we have that we cook on or put hot things on and do processing and things like that. This right dotted or this left dotted line right here is where we're going to cut the plywood, because what I like to do is I like to have a dish drain to dry my dishes. I don't like drying them all with a towel because it takes too long. And so what I do is I take and I usually make a cut in whatever plywood or countertop I'm using, and I put hinges on the left side right where my fingers are, and so that way it'll hinge up and expose it'll expose the under cabinet, which is right here, and in that cavity right there we'll put a dish drain, so that way when we're done we can put the countertop right back on. You'll never know it's there, and then when you need to dry your dishes or take them back out, you open it right up and you have your dishes accessible, and that makes it really, really convenient. So we're going to do that, and then we will have a 2x4 going across on the left and right for support, because the sink will obviously hold a lot of water, and so the water is heavy, so you're going to need a good amount of support. So this 2x4 will probably be on edge like this, and this 2x4, I might have two of them stacked on top of each other wide ways to allow more support and more overlap for these two pieces overlapping onto it. Maybe I might get by with just having one piece like this, but I might throw in two if I don't think it's strong enough. So that's how that's going to be. We'll have our 2x4 legs on each corner, obviously. And as you can see up here, this will be the front view of that. These are both bird's eye views. The front, I left a lot of it out because I'll explain that in more detail as we go on along in the series. But basically, we'll just have 2x4 legs, and that will give us the support we're needing within our stretchers going across either side, and the left and right, or I guess the left and right in front of the back, will be 3 inches off the ground, so we'll create legs that actually stick out beyond the actual floor, so that way we can level it a lot easier than if we had a full 2x4 laying on the ground. So that's pretty much it for the basic dimensions. I'll reference this later a little bit more, because when we get into actual dimensions, you know, like this is going to be 25 inches from this edge to the left side of the sink, and then it'll be 39 from the left edge to the right side of the sink. And I'll get more detail into that, and I'll try and throw up a picture for you guys somewhere along here where you can see these dimensions. And so that way you guys can build one of these to spec exactly like I have yourself. I think I've included all the dimensions you need to make one yourself fairly easy, and then I will obviously reference more dimensions as we go along. So that's pretty much it for the boring part of it. Let's go ahead and break out these 2x4s that I got sitting right in front of the camera here, bring them back up to the house, and we'll start cutting them to the size, and we'll start making our cabinet. So we have the main top laid out and screwed and nailed in. I do one deck screw and one nail on each side because I'm trying to use the least amount of deck screws as possible because they are pretty expensive. And once again, I'm trying to do this on the cheap. The nails I'm using are actually off of a nail gun off of a construction site. I found these laying on the road, actually. So I have quite a few reams of these, and so that's what I'll be using my nails. So once again, those are free. And these are drywall nails, so they're not, or screws, so they're not the most expensive either. So, once again, trying to do it on the cheap. This is actually upside down right now, I believe. No, never mind. It's upright. So basically, the overall length is 60 inches, so 5 feet width, but they are actually cut at 57 because the 2x4s go on the side. And that is so when we put our legs on, pretend this is our leg, it spans the gap between the two, like so, because if this was going all the way through, like say this was our width and it was just like this, it wouldn't be quite as strong. So I cut these at 57 and these at 24 inches, so that way it'll bridge the gap and it'll be a little bit stronger. I hope you guys can see that, what I'm talking about there, how it bridges the gap between the two right here. Maybe you can see over here a little bit better. Bridges that gap quite nicely. So we'll go ahead and do our two inside here. We already have those dimensions laid out. Let me go ahead and grab my sheet here. So once we have our main top laid out and we have our sides and our width cut, 24 inches, 57 inches for a total of 60 inches of width and 24 inches of depth, we're going to cut our inside pieces, which are going to be 14 inches from the inside. And of course, my pencil's sitting over here. Give me 1 second. 14 inches from the inside puts us right here. And we'll just put an X on this side to know to put the 2x4 over there. Do the same thing right here. And then that will be, again, not on edge, but laying flat to give us the best overlap for our dish drain and for this and for the sink. So that one will actually work nicely because it'll fit right in there. So 14 inches And then the next one, I haven't quite laid out yet. So I guess I'll have to find that dimension. And then when I bring you guys back, I'll show that to you as well. So stay with me, guys. Alright guys, well I'm pretty much out of light for the day, so I might keep working for a little bit after dark, but I won't be filming anymore because of the light. So whatever I get done tonight, you guys unfortunately won't see, but when we pick this up tomorrow, hopefully I can get it finished tomorrow. That's a good guess of what's going to happen, but I doubt I'll finish it. So all I'm going to do today is just put these legs on. I cut them at 30 and a half inches to give us an overall height of 34 inches. I think that's a good height. Luckily, since we're on a gravel floor, we can easily build up or take down to get the approximate height that we'd like. But this seems to be a good height for me. So I'm not very tall, so I don't need a very tall setup. All I'm going to do for tonight is just toenail it in, and I'm going to do some bracing either tonight or tomorrow, depending on how much I feel like doing tonight. As you can see, once again, that leg bridges the gap of those two very nicely. Let me get a bit on here. I don't like toenailing necessarily, unless I have like a pocket screw jig, but it's good enough just for initial support. See that eventually pulled it tight, and it's nowhere near stable, but it's good enough for tonight.